So Magic Johnson,
you reached out to us, the black man. I'ma tell you something, man. We seen how you raised your kids. Matter of fact, how you raised your little boy to be a strong, black, grown, independent woman. We seen that. We seen how you cheated on every female you ever been with. We seen how you bragged about sleeping with over 5,000 females, but you wanna reach out to us, the black men. I'ma tell you something, man. We got no respect for you, okay? Don't say nothing to us. You can't talk for us, okay? You got no voice. And that's all I'ma say.
Now, there's a lot of black men in here, and I don't mean to.
All right, here we go. Here we go. Let's get it.
So, not talk to other people, but this is important. Our black men, we got to get them out to vote. That's number one.
I see. All right, they didn't send a nigga catcher out the picture. So let's see what they pitching.
Kamala's opponent promised a lot of things last time to the black community that he did not deliver on. And we gotta make sure we help black men understand that.
So I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
Let me tell you.
We don't care.
That's why I'm here, to make sure I help black men understand. First, get out and vote, and then vote for the next president of the United States, Kamala Harris. She's for women's rights to make their own decision with their body. We got to clap for that.
I'm here to tell you right now, we don't care.
We don't care.
That was his pitch to black men. Tito, this is your clip. I know you chomping at the bit, but before I hand it over to you, we've been pushing this talking point, me and Saul, very hard, and this just walked right into it. What we say, if you, 2024, if you a Democrat, black male, voting Democrat, there ain't nothing in it if you are a heterosexual, productive black male. Give you this jump clip.
That's the Democrat Party. Party perverts, liars, psychopaths, and anti-Christian bigots, all tied into one. Yeah, this sister came out and spilled the beans on all of y'all. She said that she believed that about 90% of the men that vote for the Democrat Party are gay. I'm going to take that to 100.
It's all yours, Tito. That's Magic Johnson's son. That wasn't his girlfriend. Go ahead.
I know who that is. Man. I can only imagine how his father feels being a Midwesterner, coming from probably a similar background as me, with people that's in manufacturing, because that's mostly what we used to do here in the Midwest. And coming from working at all places, the Fisher body fabrication shop. That's wild. I never knew that his father worked there. That was interesting to find that out just now. But and for those of you that don't know, Fisher body fabrication shop actually started out as a company that made horse carriages, and then they later made the bodies for Cadillacs, Buicks, for GM. That's why you see Body by Fisher down there in the rocker panel in the driver's side door. Anyway, so, wow, yeah, he walked right into this. He walked right into this like Tony Montana at the top of the staircase, man.
I had to do him dirty. He walked right into my talking point.
This clip has it all. this clip has it all. When we talk about the way that the Democratic Party comes at as straight so-called black men, this clip has it all. Number one, it's got somebody that's speaking from a position of like outrageous privilege, but trying to connect to somebody who has a position of little or no privilege, and doing it in a condescending manner at that. It's got that, right? I mean, look, like one of the brothers just said, Magic Johnson hasn't been middle class since the Carter administration, and probably before then, because trust me, it was envelopes even before the NILs in college. It was envelopes being put in lockers. You know, I played at the junior college. I got envelopes in my locker, so I know he did at Michigan State. Okay, so he probably hasn't been middle class since the Ford administration, right? So it's somebody speaking from a, of course, it's a baby boomer. It's that mixed into the old nigga shit, right?
Yeah, he all the metrics. He an old boomer nigga. The whatchamacallit, and he and you can clearly see why he's pushing the Democratic agenda. It's close in the family.
Yeah. And somebody speaking from a stultified position of privilege, and speaking down to somebody who has little or no privilege, and doing it in a condescending manner. And in that condescending manner, he almost is speaking to so-called straight black men like children, just the same way that everybody else in the Democratic Party does. Listen to how baby fat his message sound. I'm letting black men know that they have to get out and vote. Okay. And vote for the next president. He didn't tell you anything that's in it for you. He didn't tell you why you should do it. He just told you that you should do it because, let's just be clear here, you are publicly traded chattel in the United States as a so-called black man. You are publicly traded chattel, especially as a so-called black man in your own community. So he's basically commanding you. He's not imploring you. He's not trying to persuade you. He's commanding you on their behalf. That's all he's doing. This is all of the shit that we complain about right here, all in one nutshell. This is everything that we complain about. And then it's like, you look crazy. You can't even get your own son to, I'm not even going to go there, but you want us, you can't even persuade your own son to be a regular individual, but you want to persuade us to go.
No, you spot on. I mean, that's kind of why I played the clip, like the fucking irony. The irony.
Yeah, this is like totally the wrong person that they ever could have had to stump for them.
We popularized this talking point. What say you, sir?
What a disappointment, because one of my favorite teams of all time was the Showtime era, the Lakers. You know what I mean? I might have to take some shit off the wall and, you know, just put it in the garage for a little bit. You know what I mean?
Hell yeah.
But how can I trust a man to talk to black men when he doesn't even have his own household in order?
That's a whole fact, though.
Right? And not even just his own household. I'm talking about the physical one where he's dealing with his son, but also his own household, physical household.
All these big celebrity endorsements tell me one thing. Kamala Harris' campaign is in trouble. So she just got an endorsement from Bruce Springsteen earlier this week. And then she also got another endorsement from Magic Johnson. He appeared at a rally encouraging black male voters in particular to support Kamala Harris. Now, why do you think a multimillionaire like Irvin Magic Johnson would take some time out of his day to come to a rally and appeal specifically to black male voters? It's because the Democrats know that they have been losing their base over the last few years. They know that black male voters in particular have been leaving them. Several studies have been conducted that have showed black male voters under the age of 55 more likely to vote for Trump. I even saw one study that said black male voters under the age of 55, 25% of them said that they were voting for Trump. And this is only people who said they're voting for Trump. This is not people who are secret Trump voters who are going to the poll voting for Trump, but pretending to vote for Kamala Harris so that they don't get the backlash the rest of us get. Barack Obama also announced yesterday that he is going to start a 27-day campaign to endorse Kamala Harris. Now think about that. Usually somebody like Barack Obama would come out to support a candidate 2 weeks or so before the election. The fact that he is willing to do a 27-day campaign starting now until the election lets us know that the Democratic Party is in trouble.